So before we can share classrooms between each other, we just need to add a colleague in the first place. And you can do that from this Classes tab here. And it's going to be over on the left side at the bottom, this button that just says Colleagues. And I already have one added on here. This is the one that I'm going to use as an example. So I'm going to just take that off real quick. And if you don't have any colleagues added, it's going to be blank. It'll just say add colleague. So you're just going to click on that button and it'll ask you to enter the email of the account that you want to add. So I'm going to go ahead and type it in here, colleague@gmail.com. And then you're going to hit OK. And then you'll see it'll pop up as a pending request. So the teacher's name will pop up if they have a name set. If they have a profile picture set, it'll also show up and then it'll list that email again, which is good just in case you may have accidentally put in a typo. You can always double check it here and then just remove it if it's the wrong one. So you can see it's pending. So right now, there's not much else we can do from this teacher's side. You can always go back to your colleagues tab and it'll still show up as pending. So I'm going to go ahead and go into the other teacher's account so we can see what's going on from their side. From the other teacher's side, they are going to get an email that'll say that they've received a colleague request and it'll show them the teacher name as well as the email address. And it'll say, please sign in to accept it. So we're just going to pop into our Boom account here. So this is the other one. So from the teacher who was invited, they'll log in and from their Classes tab on their Colleagues button, they'll see a little red notification number. So when they click on that, they'll open it up. It won't say anything in the Colleagues tab just yet because we don't have one added, but there's also the Requests tab. So they'll want to click on that. It has the little one in the parentheses, and you can see that there's that invitation that I sent for my Miss Christine account. And to accept it, they just want to click that confirm button. And it'll get that confirmation message that it was added successfully. And now you'll see that that account is listed in the Colleagues tab instead of the Requests one. So now these two accounts are colleagues. So they're connected. We can share students between them. Do you have any questions yet, or does it make sense so far? Perfect. Awesome. Okay. So now, as Miss Christine, I want to share one of my classrooms to my co-teacher. So I'm going to minimize this window here and go back to my Miss Christine account. And I have this handy dandy classroom created named co-teaching class, so I know which one to share. And we have five students set up, and I want to share all of them with my co-teacher. So to share them with your colleague, you'll want to click this button here that says Share Students with Colleague. And it'll pop up with this box that asks you to select which students you'd like to do or you'd like to share. Now, if you wanted to share all of them, you can just click the one that says All Students in Classroom. But if you have a situation where maybe one of your students has like a paraeducator or something like that, you just wanted to share one of them, you can select them individually, and it'll just share that one instead of the whole classroom. But we're going to share the whole classroom just for this example. So I'm going to click All Students in Classroom. You'll see the checkboxes appear next to all of them. And then I'm going to click Next. And it'll ask you just to confirm that you're going to be sharing five students from this co-teaching class to this teacher. And if that's all correct, you'll just click that Share button again. And then it'll pop up saying they've been shared successfully. We're going to hit OK. Nothing's going to look much different at this point. But then, if I'm going to pop over into the co-teacher account, we'll take a look here. I'm going to go back to my Classes tab. And now there's this yellow box that's appeared on the left side that says New Classroom Pending. And it'll say the teacher's name who shared the students with you and how many students they want to share with you. And I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And it'll give some more information. It'll just say, hey, this teacher wants to share five students with you. Would you like to accept it? They can accept it or they can reject it if like something got messed up or they have no idea who this teacher is, they can just click reject. You can also click cancel just to exit out of it without accepting or rejecting. But we do want to accept. And doing so, it will create a new classroom on the account. So if a teacher has a free account that's only limited to a certain number of classrooms, they might have some trouble with this. But if that is the case, they can just let us know and we can help them out with editing the classroom limit. But otherwise, it should work just fine. So I'm going to just click accept here. And then it will bring all those students into this account. So it'll say new classroom with the imported students has been created. I'll click OK. And as you can see, it's those same 5 students from before. I'll just click over to the other account so you can see as well. So we have all of them. And then on my Miss Christine account, I'm just going to refresh the page real quick to update it. When you share students with a colleague, you'll also notice that all of the students that are shared now have a little number in the corner of their profile picture. And that number signifies how many teachers the student is associated with. So right now it says 2, and it's just associated with this account and the one that I just shared it with. But you can also share students to multiple teachers. So if we had, you know, my co-teacher, but then also a teacher from a different subject or a different specialty, you can also share them to those. And as you do so, that number will increase, you know, 3, 4, 5. I don't know off the top of my head if there's a limit to how many teachers you can share a student with, but it's really convenient because then the student just has one login. They don't have a separate thing for each teacher. And when the student does log in to their assignments page, if they've been assigned decks from the different teachers, those decks will be listed in separate sections. So it'll say which classroom it's associated with. So the student then knows which assignment is for which teacher. So it's definitely a nice tool to use when you have a student with multiple educators working with them. Now, if you wanted to unshare them or remove a colleague from your account, it's really simple. You just want to use that colleagues button again. So I'll just go down to colleagues and you just want to hit that remove button over here. You'll click remove and it'll ask you to confirm just to make sure. And I'm going to hit OK. And then it'll be gone.